ओम नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो ओम श्रीभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञानघन प्रत्यगर्तो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि। नारायणं पद्मभूम वशिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्र पराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौड़पदं महांतं गोविंद योगींद्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशंकराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तंतोटकं वार्तिककारं अन्यानस्मद्गुरून् संततमानतोऽस्मि। श्रुतिस्मृति प्राणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यद्ब्रह्मगोचरविचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसारधीजनितदुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्मधीजनितसौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणीसहितकृष्णं हन्नमामि। यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरीसहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकचाङ्कमनन्तसुखाकृतिम्। We are looking at the Arthadhyasa. Among Arthadhyasa and Jnanadhyasa, we are looking at Arthadhyasa here. So, Smriti Rupaha iti, the Lakshana which is given as common to Sadi Anadi Adhyasa and which is also common to Arthadhyasa and Jnanadhyasa. The interpretation of the word by Vyutpatti difference. Difference in Vyutpatti will bring about the difference in meaning of the word, but the Lakshana will still remain the same. So the Lakshana is Paratra Avabhasaha. That is the basic Lakshana. And then the explanation of that is with Smriti Rupaha and Purva Drushtaha. Now what is Smritihi there? Smritihi, the explanation of Smritihi is different for Arthadhyasa and Jnanadhyasa. Smriti will derive as Smaryamanaha, Karmani Vitpatti, thereby leading to Arthadhyasa, whereas Smriti with Bhave Vitpatti will lead to the meaning as Jnanam and it will become Jnanadhyasa. Then Purva Drushtaha, that meaning is yet to come up. Even the Bhave Vyutpatti of Smriti is yet to come up, but Bhave Vyutpatti is something that we know by Rudhyartha. Rudhyartha of Smriti is usually memory, not that which is recalled. So it is almost always in Laukika Prayoga, it is almost always Bhave Vipatti. But here Smaryate iti Smriti for Arthadhyasa. So here there was an aropa made as to this is Anyata Khyati. Because if you say Smaryamana, then it is the Vishaya which is recalled. That is what you are seeing here. If that is the case, then this is same as Anyata Khyati as used by Tarkikas. That was answered, the doubt was removed by saying that this Smriti is Smaryamana, alright, but the word is Smriti Rupaha. It is not Smriti itself. What is seen outside in the Rajju Sarpa or the Shukti Rajata Stala, there the Vishaya seen, Artha seen is not Smaryamana Vishaya. It is Smaryamana Rupaha, meaning it is similar to that which is recollected, similar to, so smaryamana sadrishyam. So anyata khyati prasanga is not there, because tasya rupam iva smaryamana sadrusha, tasya rupam iva rupam asya iti smriti rupaha smaryamana sadrusha ityartha. Further also we saw that avabhasyati iti avabhasa, avabhasa also by karmani vyutpatti means avabhasa, and by bhavi vyutpatti it will mean avabhasa as avabhasanam by bhavi vyutpatti. So here now purva drushta, what is purva drushta? Sadrisham upapadayati, the same, the similarity. What is the similarity in the vishaya which is seen outside in the adhyasasthala? When the rajata is seen, the rajata outside, the brahma, in the brahmasthala, rajata seen outside is similar to the rajata which was recollected seen elsewhere. So anyatha all right, but not anyatha khyati. It is was seen in another place and time but recollected now, and this rajata has a similarity with that recollected vishaya, recollected silver. And that similarity, sadrisham upapadeti, what is this sadrisham? Drishtam, so that is said as purva drishta. Purva drishtaha, that smriti rupaha sadrisham there is purva drishta, due to purva drishta, what was seen earlier, that is the similarity. What was seen earlier, and there in purva drishta, what is drishta? Drishtam darshanam. Drishtam is darshanam, the seeing. The seeing, the sight of something earlier, that becomes the hetu. For what? For the similarity to appear here. The similar vastu to appear here. The similarity is the trigger here for Brahma to take place. So drishtam, purva drishta is the hetu. And what is drishta? Drishta is darshanam, the sight of the silver which was earlier. Seeing the silver itself has left some samskara, and that samskara causes this Brahma. देयरफोर संस्कार द्वारा पूर्वदर्शनाद अवभास्यते इति पूर्वदृष्ट अवभासः. जनरली दि समास वेन इट इज तत्पुरुष षष्टी वर्क्स, सो पूर्वदृष्ट अवभास विल बी पूर्वदृष्टस्य अवभासः. दिस इज दि जनरल फर्स्ट लेवल इंटरप्रिटेशन ऑफ दि समास. हाउएवर दिस इज पूर्वदृष्ट, दृष्ट बीइंग दर्शन, this is purva drishtad avabhasa, meaning purva drishtad purva darshanad hetoho avabhasaha. Avabhasyate iti avabhasaha, the object which is seen, the object that appears here right now is because of the silver seen earlier. The silver that appears here is due to the sight of silver earlier, which has left samskara. Therefore samskara dvara purva darshanat kasya rajatasya, rajatasya purva darshanat idam rajatam avabhasyate iti purva drushta avabhasa. So there avabhasyate is silver which is seen here. Tena samskara janya jnana vishayatvam smaryamana aropyeho sadrishyam uktam bhavati, and thereby tena पूर्वदृष्टेन, वन्स यू यूज द पूर्वदृष्ट अवभास, द वर्ड पूर्वदृष्ट इज एन एक्सप्लेनेशन, इट इज नॉट पार्ट ऑफ द लक्षण इट्सेल्फ. सो तेन संस्कार जन्य ज्ञान विषयत्वम इज द सादृश्यम. व्हाट इज द सिमिलैरिटी बिटवीन द रिकलेक्टेड स्मर्यमाण एंड आरोप्य? आरोप्य इज दैट विच इज अध्यस्त हियर, that which is seen here, that which is appearing here and not being there, it is appearing in shukti, that rajata is aropya, it is superimposed. So that which is superimposed here now, what is it? It is having a similarity with recollected silver. And what is that similarity here? Sadrishyam, सादृश्यम उक्तम भवति. व्हाट इज दी सिमिलैरिटी बिटवीन स्मर्यमाण रजता एंड आरोप्य रजता? दैट इज संस्कार जन्य ज्ञान विषयत्वम. दिस इज द सिमिलैरिटी. Meaning what? Samskara janya jnana vishayatvam means the smriti, meaning smaryamana, silver which is recollected. Is it samskara janya? Yes, because there was purva darshana. There was purva darshana of rajata somewhere in the shop or at home, somewhere you have seen the silver. And that left samskara. This samskara has triggered the memory. When you recollect the silver, what is that due to? That is because of the samskara generated by the sight of silver earlier. Therefore, the smriti is samskara janya. Which smriti now? Both the smriti, meaning memory, recollection itself, as well as the recollected object, silver. Both are samskara janya. But one is jnana, the other is jnana vishaya. So here, since we are dealing with arthadhyasa, what is recollected is having similarity. What is that similarity now? Vishayatvam, jnana vishayatvam. It is the vishaya of jnana. The silver is the vishaya of jnana. Which jnana? That jnana which is janya by samskara. So the jnana, the knowledge which is born out of samskara, which was left by the earlier darshana of silver, seeing silver sometime in the past, such jnana has a vishaya. What is the vishaya? The vishaya is the silver itself. Because it is knowledge regarding what? What is the object of that knowledge? It is silver itself. Now this silver being the vishaya, that silver will have vishayatvam, jnana vishayatvam. So it will have samskara janya jnana vishayatvam. Purva drishta samskar, purva drishta rajata which was there, that darshana had left a samskara, and that samskara caused this jnana to crop up, which has silver as its vishaya. So that smaryamana, smriti meaning smaryamana rajata, that rajata has samskara janya jnana vishayatvam. What about the aropya which is seen outside? The silver which is seen outside, that is aropya. That also has this samskara janya jnana vishayatvam. How so? Because this silver which appears outside, that is a vishaya of jnana. So it has jnana vishayatvam. But what kind of jnana? That jnana is also born out of samskara, because without the samskara of the earlier seen silver, seeing of the silver earlier, there wouldn't have been Brahma. Nobody has a Brahma of silver if silver is not known to that person. If one has never seen Sarpa, one cannot have Rajju Sarpa Brahma. One should have seen Sarpa, if not a real Sarpa, at least on, you know, National Geography or something. On TV he should have seen, or in a picture book or something. Without that there cannot be a Brahma. There may be Brahma of something, but not Sarpa if the Sarpa is not seen. Therefore, when the Aropya is seen here, something is Aropya here, something is superimposed, then that superimposed should have been seen earlier by the person who has that Brahma, who is seeing that Aropya. Therefore, that Aropya is also Samskara Janya Jnana Vishaya, and it has Samskara Janya Jnana Vishayatvam. This is the similarity. Sadrishyam Uktam Bhavati Kayoho Smaryamana Rajata Aropya Rajatayoho. Between the seen silver and the recollected silver, the similarity is both are Samskara Janya Jnana Vishaya, and therefore both have this dharma called Samskara Janya Jnana Vishayatvam. Now, looking a little ahead so that it becomes easier. Now, when you compare this to smritihi, which is not smaryamana, smaranam smritihi by bhavi vyutpatti, that will mean jnana, because smriti is also jnana. What is anubhavaha? Anubhava is also jnana. Smriti is also jnana. Is also jnanam. Jnana, so jnanam. So smriti is jnana, anubhava is jnana, anubhava is smriti bhinna jnanam. Smriti bhinna jnanam anubhavaha. This is lakshana for anubhava. So both are jnana. Now the rajata which is seen outside and the recollected rajata both have jnana vishayatvam because both are jnana vishaya. However, smriti which is jnanam is jnanam. It is not jnana vishaya. Smriti means smarana, not smaryamana. Smaranam smritihi. By bhavi vyutpatti, that means jnana itself, not jnana vishaya. So the silver, the knowledge of silver, in jnanadhyasa, the knowledge of silver, meaning this, you have a vritti of silver which is seen outside. So this silver seen outside has samskara janya jnana vishayatvam. And that is similar to the recollected silver, the object in your mind. The recollected object in your mind has a similarity because it also has samskara janya jnana vishayatvam. But the memory of the silver, you is jnana. You have knowledge of silver within. Which silver? The knowledge of the silver you have seen earlier and you are recollecting now. So that jnana is also the jnana of silver, but we are talking about jnanadhyasa now. So when you are talking about jnanadhyasa, you know the silver which is outside because you claim to see, I am seeing silver. So seeing silver is perception, knowledge of silver, and you are also recollecting silver. So the recollection is knowledge, and the seeing of silver, sight of silver outside is also knowledge, the vision of silver outside. There is similarity among these two also. What is the similarity? They are both samskara janya jnanam. They are both samskara janya jnanam. The silver that is seen outside has jnana vishayatva. It is jnana vishaya for which jnana? It is samskara janya jnana. And that is smriti. Smaranam smriti hi also. It is having similarity with, it is not smriti hi, it is having similarity with smriti also. Which is smaranam smriti hi. Which is also samskara janya jnana. Therefore, there is similarity between the object of this knowledge and the object of memory, which is what samskara janya jnana vishayatvam. And there is a similarity between two units of knowledge also. One is the knowledge of the silver outside, seen outside in the brahmasthala, and the knowledge of silver which is recollected. So the recollection, between recollection and the sight of the silver outside, the vision of the silver, the perception, there is a commonality. What is the commonality? Samskara janya jnanam. So this is going to be said later, but I want to show you right now that there is similarity. One is jnana similarity, the other is jnana vishaya similarity. The object has jnana vishaya similarity, whether it is recollected or seen outside, and the jnana of the object seen outside or recollected, there is a similarity of being jnana, samskara janya jnana. Okay. So they will have samskara janya jnanatvam. Both the recollection, smritihi, swaranam smritihi, and the avabhasanam, avabhasa outside, the vishaya. Vishaya which is seen, is being seen, the sight of the vishaya. The sight of the vishaya meaning the perception of the vishaya, the jnana of the vishaya, and the jnana of the recollected silver, both have samskara janya jnanatvam. Thereby, tena samskara janya jnana vishayatvam smaryamana aropyayoho sadrishya muktam bhavati. So there is a similarity between the object seen and the object recollected for arthadhyasa. Smritya aropayoho samskara janyatvat. Why so? Because both smriti meaning smaryamana vishayaha, the recollected silver, and the here it is said smriti and arop. Here it is not smriti as smaryamana vishaya, but Smriti is, can be taken as Smriti itself, Smaranam Smriti. And Aropa, not Aropya, Aropa. Aropa is the superimposition. So between the memory, Jnana, and the Aropa, which is superimposition, Jnana, what is the commonality? Both are Samskara Janya. Both are Samskara Janya Jnana. So both have Samskara Jnanatvam. And the object of both of these, one is outside, the other is in the mind, recollected. Both have Samskara Janya Jnana Vishayatvam. But both are also Samskara Janya. Samskara Janyatvam is common in Jnana also and in Jnana Vishayatvam also. Nacha Samskara Janyatvad Aropasya Smrutitvapattir iti Vachyam. Now, how will you differentiate if both are Samskara Janya? Meaning, if the Vishaya seen outside is Samskara Janya and the Vishaya which is recollected is also Samskara Janya, how will you make a difference between the two? So you can say what is seen outside is just in your mind. It is just recollected object. Both are Samskara Janya. So the Puropakshi asks that and the Siddhanti says, Nachavachyam. You should not say that because the object seen outside and the object of the memory both are Samskara Janya. Therefore, not the object here, the because you can take object also. The object is same or it is memory itself. What you are seeing is your memory. It is nothing as Brahma outside. There is no object outside. It is just your plain memory. That's all it is. It is Smriti itself. Why do you make a difference between the sight outside or the object outside and the memory or the object of memory inside? Why do you have to make a difference? Because both are Smriti Janya. You cannot differentiate between the two. Iti Nacha Vachyam, says the Siddhanti. Why? Because just because there is commonality, it does not mean that both are same. Similarity in two things do not make both of the things same, because there are differences also. When we give an example, people jump the gun and say that it is all same. For example, when we say, okay, Buddhists also talk about some kind of mithyatvam, and Advaitins also talk about some kind of mithyatvam, and then Dvaitins will jump the gun, knowingly or unknowingly, and they'll say, oh, this is Bauddhavada. Advaita Vedanta is Bauddhavada. It is not so. Just because there is some commonality does not make both same. There are huge differences between Shunyavada or Kshanika Vijnanavada and Advaita. Huge differences. Those cannot be discounted just because you are comparing some similarity. Similarly here, Samskara Janyatvam may be same in Smriti and Aropa. Similarly in Smaryamana and Aropya, there may be Samskara Janyatvam. However, there are differences also. Dosha Samprayoga Janyatvasya Api Vivakshitatvena Samskara Matra Janyatva Bhavat. Samskara Matra Janyatvam isn't there. In Smriti, there is Samskara Matra Janyatvam. The memory is only due to Samskara, not anything else. You don't need any other Samagri. There is nothing else needed to recollect. If there is Samskara, then there is a possibility of recollection. That's all. Only Samskara is needed. Nothing else is needed. That is common here also, meaning this Samskara is needed in the Brahmasthala, but Samskara itself is not sufficient. What else is needed? There are some doshas also. Whether they are Vishayagata dosha or meaning Pramayagata dosha or Pramatragata dosha. Some doshas are there. Then Samprayoga and of course Pramaya and Pramata I mentioned. Pramana also. Pramanagata dosha may also be there. One does not have a good eyesight. Therefore there is Brahma. Ekaschandra Sadvitiyat Vad Avabhasate. तथा च लोके अनुभवः इट इज अनुभव सिद्ध एज टू इफ देर इज प्रमाणगत दोष ऑल्सो देन ऑल्सो देर मे बी भ्रम और वन इज नॉट एबल टू सी एट अ डिस्टेंस शॉर्ट साइटेड वन इज नॉट एबल टू सी इन इनसफिशियंट लाइट दैट इनसफिशियंस इज सब्जेक्टिव देन देर कैन बी अदर दोषाज लाइक प्रमातृगत दोष द प्रमाता हिमसेल्फ इज अ लिटिल बिट ऑफ अ डल काइंड ऑफ अ पर्सन और देर कैन बी और डज नॉट नो सफिशियंट सो मंद और देर कैन बी प्रमेयगत दोष ऑल्सो द ऑब्जेक्ट इट सेल्फ यू नो मे सिल्वर इफ यू आर लुकिंग एट द शेल इट सेल्फ दैट शेल इज मे बी नॉट अ रेगुलर शेल इट इज सम शेल विच इज मैन मेड एंड इट इज मेड लाइक सिल्वर सो इट विल हैव सम दोषाज इट इज नॉट वाइट द वे इट इज something else you know some comparison or a rope itself rope appears as snake the rope may have dosha that rope itself is created in such a manner that it looks like a snake that is the dosha of the rope it is the rope is made in such a manner so whatever it is there are some doshas which are expected samskara alone is not sufficient then samprayoga samprayoga is samsarga some kind of sambandha is there is some connection which is needed So the aropya and the adhikarana has some samsarga. What is that samsarga? We'll see more. Samprayoga. In this case, what is a samprayoga? Idantva jnana should be there. Samanya jnana itself is samsarga. You know this. You have the samanya jnana. Idantvam of the shukti is known. You know something is there. The adhishthana samanya jnana itself is samprayoga. For the aropa. To take place. So that is samprayoga here. That is also expected because samanya jnana is expected if it is pitch dark. If it is not a twilight zone. If it is pitch dark, then you won't see anything. A person who sees nothing in front of him will not have rajju sarpa darshana. That kind of brahma is not possible. The idamamsha of rajju should be visible, meaning there is something. There is something here. That much unit of information should be there. That knowledge should take place. Without that, Brahma of Sarpa is not possible. One who does not see a shell at all, meaning that there is something on the beach, if one does not see that, if he sees plain sand, there cannot be Brahma of silver. The silver can be seen only when he sees something on the beach there is something in the sand out there and which shines then alone one can have brahma of rajata therefore samprayoga is needed therefore dosha samprayoga janyatvasya api vivakshitatvena that is intended there is an intention to say that there is dosha expected samprayoga expected only then there can be aropa possible so adhyasa stala has that difference and thereby samskara matra janyatvasya abhavat in the aropa there is an expectancy there is dependency on dosha and samprayoga also it is not merely samskara matra janya therefore it is not only smriti it is not same as smriti you cannot say that there is no adhyasa it is all smriti atra samprayoga shabdena adhisthana samanya jnanam uchyate This is needed. This information, this knowledge, this part of knowledge is necessary for Brahma to take place. Unless there is Samanya Jnana, there cannot be Vishesha Jnana. And Vishesha Jnana of the Shuktika as Shuktika is not there. Therefore, with Samanya Jnana of Idam, there is Vishesha Jnana of Rajata possible. So, Atra Samprayoga Shabdena, there is Samprayoga expected, meaning samsarga expected and what is this samsarga this samskara samsarga is not the samsarga the way ghata and bhutala have a samsarga that kind of samsarga is not possible here therefore what is the samprayoga here adhisthana samanya jnanam why so ahankara adhyase indriya samprayoga labhat So the samsarga, generally what is the samsarga? The indriya vishaya samsarga is talked about. Here the samsarga is there. What is the samsarga? The idantva is known. Therefore the pramatru has no connection with the shuktika, with the shuktika, shukti rajata, with the indriya. All the way there is no pramana janyatvam there. There is no indriya connection there with the rajata. So idantva connection is there. Therefore, ahankara adhyasa, in the case of ahankara adhyasa though, in the exemplified, there is no indriya samprayoga labha. There is no possibility of indriya connecting to the ahankara and atma. But in the example case, shuktika has indriya samprayoga, rajata cannot be said to be real. So the indriya which operates in the vyavahara cannot have connection with the rajata which is not vyavaharika there. Anirvachanya utpatti has to be talked about. It is a brahmasthala, it is a pratibhasika sthala. So the vyavaharika indriya cannot have samsarga, samprayoga with the pratibhasika rajata. But adhikarana adhisthana or adhikarana samanya jnana is there. Therefore, idantva, how do you know the idantva? That is known through the indriya samprayoga. But in the case of the ahankara, exemplified, ahankara adhyase, I am this sharira, I am this individual person. So, the individuality which is born out of connection with the koshas, vijnanamaya kosha here, in that case, there cannot be any indriya samsarga. Therefore, what is that? Adhisthana samanya jnanam. Atma is known samanyataha. Samanyata it is known. One may not know correctly as to who am I, but one has no doubt as to I exist and I am a conscious entity. I existed in deep sleep, therefore samanya jnana is there. Then there is a bhrama additionally as to an individual, a man, a woman, in a particular varna, with a particular dharma, with a particular family, with a particular job, etc. All that is later. That adhyasa is possible only when I know myself as I. Without my being a conscious existent entity, without my knowledge of my being an existent conscious entity, I cannot claim to be a man or a woman or whatever. That is possible next, but adhisthana atma samana jnana is definitely needed there also, and that itself is samprayoga in the exemplified. Evancha dosha samprayoga samskara balat shuktyadu rajatam utpannam asti iti paratra avabhasyatva lakshanam upapannam iti smriti rupa purvadrushta padabhyam upapaditam. So dosha samprayoga janya, evancha dosha samprayoga samskara balat. Three things. Samskara is common. Samskara janyatvam is common. And therefore, the Purvapakshi said, then how will you make a difference between the two? There is no aropa, there is only smriti. No, there is a difference, said the Siddhanti. There is dosha and samprayoga also in the brahmasthala. So, brahmasthala is not same as smriti. Therefore, three things are there. Dosha samprayoga samskara traya. Dosha samprayoga and samskara are needed for Brahma to take place, whereas samskara itself is sufficient in the case of smriti. Due to the force of this, there is an influence of dosha, samprayoga and samskara, and under the influence of these three, the triad, shuktyadau rajatam utpannam. Utpannam asti. So the rajata is born, it is born utpannam, anirvachanya utpatti. Anirvachanya khyati vada says rajata is there because it is seen and because it is seen outside. Rajata is there outside. What kind of rajata? That is debatable. But Rajata is there and it has to be outside. It is not within the mind. It is not Shunyavada or it is not Kshanika Vijnanavada. We say that there is a Rajata outside because it is seen outside. No other reasoning needed. Is it seen outside? Yes. Then it has to be outside. Okay. Of course, there can be a further debate on this with Drishti Drishti Vada in mind as to comparison with dream also. In dream also, you see a Vishaya outside. So, Kshanika Vijnana Vadi or a Drishti Drishti Vadi in Advaita itself can object to this. One can say, how do you say that there is a Vishaya outside? In dream also, there is a Vishaya seen outside. Just because it is seen outside does not make it that make it so that it has to be outside. But that's a different story. However, when we say that there is a prapancha outside and we differentiate between the waking state and the dream state, then you have to differentiate there as to in waking state there is an object outside. And if there is an object outside and you are waking and instead of seeing that object, you are seeing some other object, but you are seeing outside, then how is that possible? You are not dreaming. You are in a waking state where you are seeing everything else outside. You are seeing the mountain outside. You are seeing the forest area outside. You are seeing the path that you are walking on. Additionally, instead of the rope in front of you, you are seeing the snake. So that snake is seen outside. How can the snake be within while you are seeing every other things outside? So this can be the difference between the dream and waking. Because in the dream itself, when you are seeing everything outside, that time you are seeing Rajju or Sarpa. Imagine that you are seeing Rajju in the dream, in the forest area. The forest seen outside and the Rajju seen outside both have the same level or same place of existence. There is no differentiation possible further in the dream. But if at all, let's say you see Rajju Sarpa there and you see in the dream that there are friends along with you who are seeing Rajju there, but you are seeing snake. How will you differentiate between the snake seen outside and the Rajju seen by others outside, which both are inside your mind? How will you make a difference out of them? So it gets further complicated there. Simpler solution is of course Drishti Srishti Vada, but then that itself is complex. One answer fits all questions. However, coming back to the context, dosha samprayoga samskara balat shuktyadav rajatam utpannam asti. There is rajata outside. Because you are seeing everything else outside, one part which you have missed and you see another part outside, that cannot be within. So that also has to be outside. Thereby, the Siddhanti insists that there is utpatti of rajata outside. Utpannamasti iti paratra avabhasyatva lakshanam upapannam. Thereby, paratra avabhasyatva is the lakshana of adhyasa. Adhyasasya lakshanam kim paratra avabhasyatvam adhyastatvam. This is the lakshana upapannam, and it is fitting. The explanation given shows that the adhyasa lakshana as paratra avabhasya is fitting. Iti smriti rupa purvadrishta padabhyam upapaditam. And this explanation given as smriti rupa and purvadrishta, that is also fitting for the basic lakshana of paratra avabhasyatvam. So it is elaborated by the words smriti rupaha and purvadrishta. Purvadrishta is in samasa with avabhasya. Purvadrishta paratra smriti rupa paratra purvadrishta avabhasa. Purvadrishta avabhasa. So purvadrishta and smriti rupa are explanations for the basic lakshana paratra avabhasyatvam. Now what do others say?
अन्ये तु ताभ्यां दोषादि त्रयजन्यत्वं कार्याध्यास लक्षणं उक्तम् इति आहुः. व्हाट द अदर्स से, द अदर्स से अदर्स मीनिंग हियर दे कैन बी विद इन द संप्रदाय इटसेल्फ. सो अन्ये तु ताभ्यां, ताभ्यां मीनिंग थ्रू दीज टू वर्ड्स. विच आर दीज टू वर्ड्स? स्मृति रूप एंड पूर्वदृष्ट. सो ताभ्यां स्मृति रूप पूर्वदृष्ट पदाभ्यां दोषादि त्रय जन्यत्वं. विच आर दि दोषादि त्रय? दोष संप्रयोग संस्कार त्रय जन्यत्वं कार्याध्यास लक्षणं उक्तम् इति आहुः. सो थ्रू दि स्मृति रूप एंड पूर्वदृष्ट अदर्स से दैट थ्रू दैट दोषादि त्रय जन्यत्वं दैट इज इंडिकेटेड as what karyadhyasa in the place of adhyasa, which is a karya. That is the lakshana of karyadhyasa. Whereas some others, aparetu, aparetu smriti rupaha smaryamana sadrushaha sadrushyam cha pramana ajanya jnana vishayatvam smrityarupayoho pramana ajanyatvat. Whereas some others say as what? स्मृति रूप, बाय स्मृति रूप व्हाट इज मेंट? दे से दैट स्मृति रूप मीन्स स्मर्यमाण सदृशः, विच इज सेम एज अर्लियर व्हाट वी हैव सीन. स्मृतेः स्मर्यमाणस्य रूपमिव रूपम अस्य इति स्मृति रूपः. सो दैट ऑब्जेक्ट विच हैज सिमिलरिटी टू दी object recollected, that object seen outside has similarity to the object recollected, that is smriti rupa. However, what is the difference in sadrishyam? What is the similarity? Earlier what was the similarity? The similarity between the object recollected and that seen outside, earlier the similarity was संस्कार जन्य ज्ञान विषयत्वम. However, some others says there is a different similarity. What is the similarity between the two? The object seen and the object recollected. प्रमाण अजन्य ज्ञान विषयत्वम. This is the similarity. The object, the silver that is seen outside, स्मर्यमाण, what is that? That is प्रमाण अजन्य. Is it प्रमाण अजन्य? If it is प्रमाण अजन्य, it will become प्रमा. Prama Vishaya. The object seen outside will become Prama Vishaya if it is Pramana Janya. Because what is Pramana Janya? Pramana Janya is Prama. And that Jnana will no longer be Brahma. It will become, if it is Pramana Janya, it will be Pramana Janya Jnana will become Prama. And Prama Vishaya is not an object which is not there. It has to be there. However, the Vishaya which is seen outside, it is not प्रमा विषय, इट इज भ्रम विषय. इट इज नॉट प्रमा विषय. सो इट विल नॉट हैव प्रमा विषयत्व. इट विल नॉट हैव प्रमाण जन्य ज्ञान विषयत्व. इट विल हैव प्रमाण अजन्य ज्ञान विषयत्व. सिमिलरली द रिकलेक्टेड ऑब्जेक्ट, द रिकलेक्टेड ऑब्जेक्ट इज वॉट? द रिकलेक्टेड ऑब्जेक्ट इज ऑल्सो नॉट प्रमाण जन्य. अदरवाइज स्मृति विल बिकम वॉट? इट विल बिकम Prama. Of course, Prama Smriti, as Prama is possible, as in Smriti is also divided as what? Yatharta Smriti and Ayatharta Smriti, possible. What you recollect is Yatharta Smriti. However, what happens is that it has left a Sanskara. That Sanskara, Sanskara Janyatvam is there. It is not directly Prama Janya. It can be Brahmajanya also. No? Brahmajanya also. Brahma can also leave a smriti. Oh, I saw a snake once. There was no snake. There was a rope. But then it will leave a samskara, and next time you look at something which appears like a snake, you recollect. Oh, last time I saw rope as snake. So that samskara is there. And now you say, oh, is this a snake or a rope? Because last time I have had Brahma, this can also be a Brahma. In the similar area, in these woods, I had this Brahma. So that is also possible. And bhaya is also there. So there is a pramatrgata dosha may be there as to bhaya. However, pramana ajanya jnana vishayatvam is there in smriti as well. It is samskara janya, not pramana janya. So pramana ajanya jnana vishayatvam is there in the recollected object. In the object seen outside also there is pramana ajanya jnana vishayatvam, and that is the sadrishyam. So sadrishyam cha pramana ajanya jnana vishayatvam smrityaropayoho pramana ajanyatvat, because both the memory and smriti and aropa, the superimposition outside, is pramana ajanya. It is not prama. Pura drishta pada tajjatiya param. Now what is pura drishta? By pura drishta, what is meant by the pada pura drishta? When you say there is purva drishta abhasa, what have we seen there? Purva drishtat abhasaha, purva drishtat purva darshanad hetoho abhasaha. The appearance or the object that appears is due to the darshana, the sight of the same object earlier. But purva drishta, if you say purva drishta, that is the cause, all right. But then in this case here, when you say purva drishta, smriti rupa is explained as smaramyana sadrusha, and sadrusham has been explained differently. Here what is purva drishta? Purva drishta is purva drishta pada is what? Tat jatiya param. Purva drishta jat, tat is purva drishta. So purva drishta pada, purva drishta jatiya param. It stands for something which is falling in the category of that. If you have seen silver earlier, it is not the same silver which is seen here. Something similar, something in the same category. Why? Because abhinav rajatadehe purva drishtatva bhavat. This purva drishta avabhasa, what you see outside, is not that which you recollect. That recollected silver is elsewhere. You have seen it elsewhere in a different time and place. It is not the same silver. This is aparetu, this interpretation, not the earlier interpretation. In the earlier interpretation, we saw that purva drishtat purva darshanat avabhasaha, avabhasyate iti avabhasaha. It is due to the earlier sight. Here what is being said, purva drishta avabhasaha. What is seen outside is seen earlier. It is not the same thing that is seen earlier. It is in the same category of what which was seen earlier. So this explanation is different. Purva drishta pada tad jatiya param. It falls in that jati. It is in that species. So if you have seen a sarpa sometime, it is not the same sarpa here. It is some kind of sarpa. It is a sarpa, all right. It is not the same sarpa you have seen earlier, but it is in the species of sarpas. Some kind of snake. Snake is a species there, and then in the species of snake, some snake you are seeing here. And that is the reason that there is that similarity, and due to it being in the same species, there is a possibility of Brahma here. That made it possible. So purva drishta pada tad jatiya param abhinav rajatadehe purva drishtatva bhavat. So in the new silver that is seen outside, or the new sarpa which is seen outside, it is not the same which is seen earlier. It cannot be, because it is born anew here. So by abhinava, what is meant here is that there is an anirvachani utpatti as well of rajata or sarpa as well. Tathacha pramana ajanya jnana vishyatve sati purva drishta jatiyatvam pratitika adhyasa lakshanam tabhya muktam. So with smriti rupa and purva drishta being explained in this manner, the paratra avabhasaha, that kind of lakshana, can be extended as what lakshana now? The lakshana is expanded. Nishkrishta lakshana is pramana ajanya jnana vishayatve sati purva drishta jatiyatvam adhyasatvam. What is that? Pratitika adhyasa lakshanam. It is a lakshana of adhyasa which is pratitika. Pratitika means pratibhasika. Rajju, sarpa or shukti rajata. Tabhyam uktam. By those lakshana words which are given in the mula as what? Paratra avabhasaha. That is the only lakshana, but then when you qualify it by smriti rupa and purva drishta interpreted in this manner, aparetu smriti rupa ityadi, when interpreted in this manner, what will be the lakshana now? The lakshana is pramana ajanya jnana vishayatve sati purva drishta jatiyatvam adhyasatvam adhyastatvam, either way. So pramana ajanyatve sati, sorry, pramana ajanya jnana vishayatve sati purva drishta jatiyatvam. Why are two dalas needed? Now padakritya is done here as to comparison, not comparison, inquiry into analysis of why two words have been used here. So paratra avabhasa shabdabhyam adhyasa matra lakshanam vyakhyatam eva. So paratra avabhasa shabdabhyam, here tabhyam uktam bhavati, that is explained first. Paratra avabhasa shabdabhyam, this is the basic lakshana of adhyasa, whereas smriti rupa and purva drishta are explaining these words. So adhyasa paratra avabhasa shabdabhyam adhyasa matra lakshanam vyakhyatam eva, it has been explained by the other two words. The adhyasa means paratra avabhasa, and smriti rupa and purva drishta are explaining that. Therefore pramana ajanya jnana vishayatve sati purva drishta jatiyatvam is the adhyasa lakshana. And why two are used, these two dalas are used, those are inquired into, analyze as tatra. Tatra means in this lakshana, pramana ajanya jnana vishayatve sati purva drishta jatiyatvam. Smaryamana gangadau abhinava ghatecha ativyapti nirasaya pramana ityadi padadvayam ityahuhu. The padadvaya pramana ajanya jnana vishayatve sati purva drishta jatiyatvam. There, smaryamana gangadau. Let's say you have been to Haridwar, Rishikesh, and then many years back, let's say, and you miss it. Now you are talking to your friend, oh, I miss Rishikesh, I miss Haridwar, I loved the Ganga, it was so, you know, pristine. Back then it was even more clear waters. I mean, Ganga waters are never clear as such. So, even if you go higher up, Ganga water is not clearly, really ever that clear. But when you recollect it, you recollected this Ganga now, and Smaryamana Ganga, that Ganga is Smriti, meaning Smaryamana. It is a Smriti Vishaya. And Abhinava Ghata. There is a Ghata, which is a new Ghata here. Is there Ativyapti possible with this Lakshana in those? Meaning, if you recollect the Ganga, oh, 10 years, 15 years back, I have seen Ganga, 20 years back, whatever. There, this Ganga which is recollected, is it Purva Drishta Jatiya? Is it Pramana Ajanya Jnana Vishaya? That Ganga which is recollected is definitely Pramana Ajanya Jnana Vishaya. You are not seeing Ganga right now. So there is no Pramana for the Ganga that you are recollecting. It is not recollected through a pramana. There is no connection of indriyas with the Ganga right now. Therefore, pramana ajanya jnana vishayatva means there in smaryamana Ganga. Ganga adi, anything that is recollected. What about purva drishta jatiyatvam? If purva drishtiya jatiyatvam is not given, then what will happen? There will be ativyapti in smaryamana Ganga. However, smaryamana Ganga does not have purva drishta jatiyatvam. It has purva drishtatvam itself. It is the same Ganga that you have seen earlier. That is recollected. You are not recollecting something like Ganga. You are not saying that, I had been to Yamuna also. You are not recollecting Yamuna. You are recollecting Ganga only. The same Ganga that you have seen. Therefore, it is not having Purvadrishta Jatiyatvam. That Ganga is not Purvadrishta Jatiya, Jatiya Ganga. It is Purvadrishta Ganga itself. Therefore, this word A will take away Ativyapti in the case of Smaryamana Ganga, etc. In the case of Abhinava Ghata, there is Ativyapti possible if you don't add Pramana Ajanya Jnana Vishayatvam. Purvadrishta Jatiyatvam. This Purvadrishta Jatiyatvam is possible in New Ghata also. Because when you see a New Ghata, let's say you go to a museum or something, and then you see some kind of Ghata you have never seen. Let's say somebody has in some palatial mansion, they have some kind of Ghata which you have never seen. But we still know it is a Ghata. Why? Because there is Ghatatva Jati which is common. Ghatatva Jati is common between any Ghata that you have seen earlier and the Ghata that you are seeing in this museum or some palace which is opened up for you to have a look as to what kind of, you know, vessels they use or whatever. So, Abhinava Ghate, the Ghata that you are seeing now, it is not a new Ghata, but then for you it is new. Oh, this is new to me, I have never seen such kind of a Ghata. But how do you know it is a Ghata? Because Ghatatva Jati is there. So, Purvadrishta Ghatatva Jatiya Ghata. This Ghata is having Purvadrishta Ghatatva Jatiyatvam. Abhinava Ghata has that. If you do not say Pramana Ajanya Jnana Vishayatvam, there will be Ativyapti there. It is not a Brahma. The recollected Ganga is not a Brahma. And the Abhinava Ghata, the new Ghata that you have seen, a Ghata that you have never seen earlier, that kind of Ghata is also not a Brahma. But the Ghata that you are seeing in a palace or a museum, that is Pramana Janya Jnana Vishaya. It has Pramana Janya Jnana Vishayatvam because the Indriyas are connected there. There is Pramana Janyatvam there. Not Pramana Ajanyatvam. Therefore, Pramana Ajanya Jnana Vishayatvam will take away Ativyapti in Abhinava Ghata. Thereby, Tatra Smaryamana Gangado Abhinava Ghate cha Ativyapti Nirasaya Pramana Ityadi Padadvayam Ityahu. Therefore, these words have been used. Individually, they have to be split and taken. Tatra Arthadhyase Smaryamana Sadrusha Paratra Purdarshanad Avabhasyateti Yojana. So, to sum up, in Arthadhyasa, what is the Lakshana? Paratra Obhasaha. Paratra, Tatra Arthadhyasa, in the case of Arthadhyasa, the Lakshana is Paratra Obhasa. Adhyasa is Paratra Obhasa, Paratra Obhasa, Arthadhyasaha. Meaning, Smaryamana Sadrishaha Paratra. Smriti Rupa has been said. So, what is Paratra? Smaryamana sadrishav paratra purva darshanad avabhasyate. Due to being seen earlier, there is an appearance now. It appears, that object appears now, meaning avabhasyate. The object that appears now, the silver that appears outside now, is because of some silver seen earlier, Purva Darshanad. Where does it appear? Shuktyadav. Paratra, elsewhere it appears. Smaryamana Sadrusha, and what is it? It is similar to the object recollected. Again, why? Purva Darshanad. Because of my seeing silver earlier. Because of my seeing silver earlier, a similar silver, meaning a silver which has similarity to that I have seen earlier, due to that, a similar silver appears outside. Avabhasyate iti yojana. This is the adhyasa, arthadhyasa. What about jnanadhyasa? Jnanadhyase tu smriti sadrishav paratra purvadarshanad avabhasa iti vakyam yojaniyam iti sangshepaha. Once you understand this Arthadhyasa and commonality between the recollected object and the object seen outside, what is the similarity? Samskara Janya ज्ञान विषयत्वम. नाउ यू ड्रॉप दि विषयत्वम, यू विल लैंड ऑन मेमरी स्मृति एंड आरोप. सो ज्ञानाध्यास, ज्ञानाध्यास हैज सिमिलैरिटी. व्हाट सिमिलैरिटी? बोथ आर संस्कार जन्य ज्ञान, बोथ हैव संस्कार जन्य ज्ञानत्वम. सो ज्ञानाध्यासेषु तु स्मृति सदृश, नॉट स्मर्यमाण सदृश, स्मृति सदृश. स्मृति हियर इज नॉट स्मर्यमाण, स्मृति मीन्स स्मरणम स्मृति. सो स्मरण सदृश ज्ञानाध्यासे तु स्मरण सदृश परत्र पूर्वदर्शनाद अवभासा. अवभासा इज व्हाट? अवभासनम, अवभासा. बोथ केसेस ऑफ ज्ञानाध्यास स्मृति एज वेल एज अवभासा हैव भावी व्युत्पत्ति, एंड इन द अर्थाध्यास स्मृति एंड अवभासा हैव कर्मणि व्युत्पत्ति. इन बोथ केसेस देर इज सिमिलैरिटी. इन ज्ञानाध्यास व्हाट इज सिमिलैरिटी? स्मृति सदृश परत्र पूर्वदर्शनाद अवभासा, देर इज सिमिलैरिटी ऑफ बोथ हैविंग संस्कारजन्य ज्ञानत्वम. सो स्मृति सदृश, दिस इज सिमिलर टू मेमरी. ओ व्हाट आई सी नाउ, दिस साइट इज सिमिलर टू मेमरी. एज दो आई एम रिकलेक्टिंग, आई एम सीइंग आउटसाइड. परत्र पूर्वदर्शनाद, बिकॉज आई हैव सीन दिस अर्लियर. ओ आई हैव सीन दिस अर्लियर, दिस सिल्वर, बिकॉज ऑफ दैट आई सी silver outside. I am seeing silver outside because I have seen silver earlier. Purvadarshanad avabhasa, there is a vision of silver because of memory of silver being there. Now there is an objection here. Nanu adhyase vadi vipratipattehe katham ukta lakshana siddhi. Nanu adhyase vadi vipratipattehe, because there is vadi vipratipatti, there is no agreement, there is disagreement between various vadis, various darshanas, darshanika. Between darshanikas there is no agreement as to what adhyasa is. So how do you say, give this lakshana and get away? Nanu adhyase vadi pratipate patte he katham ukta lakshana siddhihi. This lakshana may not hold good for them. You have given a lakshana, all right, for adhyasa, arthadhyasa and jnanadhyasa. Can you say this is acceptable to others? It is not. You will have to explain how is this a lakshana which is valid. In your case you have explained, what about other darshanikas? How will you have lakshana siddhi? Iti ashankya adhisthana aropya swarupa vivade api. Siddhanti says your objection is okay, as to I have not established it in the case of other darshanikas, but it is not true that they disagree with everything. They disagree with a part maybe, but I am not insisting that they have to agree with everything. They will have to agree with adhyasa in one way or the other. My commitment is to show that there is adhyasa possible, and in the case of exemplified ahankara adhyasa, also adhyasa is possible in the same manner as adhyasa is possible outside in the rajju sarpa or the shukti rajata ityadi sthala. If they agree with that part, then in the exemplified they have no choice but to agree, because it is possible in the same manner. The manner may be different in the case of an advaitin and the other darshanikas, but adhyasa is common. Adhyasa, some kind of adhyasa has to be accepted, and we are okay with that. That much is sufficient, because we want to prove that in the ahankara adhyasa, ahankara sthala, ahankara atma, atma anatma, also adhyasa is possible. If they agree to adhyasa possible, some kind of adhyasa outside, then that same thing will extend to atma anatma sthala also in the exemplified. So iti ashankya adhisthana aropya swarupa vivade api. What is the adhisthana? What is the aropya? Although in the exact characteristic of the aropya and adhisthana, there may be disagreements, there may be differences across the darshanikas. We agree, there are. They should be there. Otherwise, it will be the same darshana. Between darshanas, if there is disagreement with the characteristic of the adhisthana and the aropya also, even if there is vivada there, paratra paravabhasa iti lakshane samvadad yuktibihi सत्याधिष्ठाने मिथ्यार्थावभास सिद्धेः सर्वतंत्र सिद्धांत इदं लक्षणं इति मत्वा अन्यता आत्मख्यातिवादिनोः मतमाह तं केचिदिति. हाउएवर देयर इज नो disagreement in paratra paravabhasa. This cannot be refuted. This will stand scrutiny also by all darshanikas. Paratra paravabhasaha adhyasaha. This much is the lakshana. Whether it is smriti rupa, purvadrushta, all that is debatable and we don't have commitment there. Paratra paravabhasa is common. Any darshanika, if you ask him, are you seeing silver that exists or that doesn't exist in the shell? So paratra it is elsewhere. Paravabhasa it is of something different than shukti. In the shukti paratra, something other than shukti para, avabhasa appears or there is an appearance. Meaning, arthadhyasa, jnanadhyasa. This much is acceptable to everyone. Iti lakshane, in this lakshana, in this definition, samvadad. There is no vivada, samvada is there. There is agreement. Due to agreement in the basic definition, lakshana of adhyasa, yukti bihi satyadhishtane, logically, through logic, all sorts of tarka, satyadhishtane mithyarthavabhasa siddhehe. Because there is siddhi. If you say, how is lakshana siddhi? Lakshana siddhi is there. How? In the adhishtana, which is satya. Is shukti there? It is there. We call it vyavaharika satta. They make say it as real, satya. Completely satya. It is satya adhishtana. Some kind of satyattvam is there in the adhishtana. Shukti exists. There can be no refutation of shukti being there. And even if they don't agree with the word mithya, still, is it satya? Is the silver which is seen is satya? If it is satya, it will never go away. Then I'll say, okay, I will give you shell, you give me silver. Will any dvaitin, will anyone give you silver just because you give shells? If so, then I will quit my job, I'll collect all the shells on the seashore and I'll sell it to the dvaitin. Sell it meaning I'll have a barter. I'll say I'll give you as many shells, you give me so many silver pieces, coins. Not possible. Why? Because that person also knows that is mithya. Silver is mithya there. So, satyadhishthane mithyartha avabhasa siddhehe. The avabhasa, whether it is avabhasyate as artha, vishaya, or avabhasanam as appearance of the silver, both are jnanadhyasa and arthadhyasa are adhyasas. The jnana and vishaya seen there, both are adhyasa as per every darshanika in this case. Thereby sarvatantra siddhantaha siddhante idam lakshanam. Sarvastantra siddhante idam lakshanam. This lakshana, tantra there is, can be taken as darshana. So every darshana has this kind of lakshana possible. They have to accept with paratra paravabhasa, because in satya adhishtana mithyartha avabhasa is there, siddhi. Thereby, idam lakshanam iti matva, sarvatantra siddhanta idam lakshanam iti matva, anyatha atma khyati vadinoho matamaha. The next section will deal with anyatha khyati vadimata and atma khyati vadimata. Others are also dealt with, but then primarily anyatha khyati and atma khyati. Anyatha khyati is of the tarkikas. And Atmakhyati is of the Shunyavadin, the Kshanika Vijnanavadin, basically Bauddhas. So, and then others also we'll see Tam Kechiriti in the next part. यद् ब्रह्म गोचर विचित्रतम प्रभावात् संसार दीजनित दुःखम अभूत् जनस्य यद् ब्रह्म दीजनित सौख्यम अभूत् तस्य तम रुक्मिणी सहित कृष्ण महं नमामि ओम तत्सत. एनी क्वेश्चंस? आई विल सी नेक्स्ट पार्ट. नमस्ते.
नमस्ते.